Hello for Tuesday, October 4th, and someone must have forgotten this is the first of the new month, the first of the new quarter, and there's supposed to be funds with money flowing into the market. I guess they were not doing that. If they were at all, they were getting a little cheaper prices. So the Dow was down about 258 points, but again, we're still in the same range we've been in since through August and through September, and not even down to the lows yet, and we're getting under that Bollinger Band. And if you look left, we did that before at the last low. We're under the Bollinger Bands, and we did that at the beginning of August when we went under there. We're under it too, and both those times, actually in those lows, we had higher volume than we had on Monday. You can see this volume is quite a bit higher, 1.5 billion. Here was 1.1, and over here it was 2 billion. So less volume each time. So we'll see if we continue lower this area, maybe down to just test that support, maybe bounce there, maybe go on lower with the panic, or if there is some. So far there isn't any. If you look at the volume indicator, at least we'll look at the futures chart here. You can see we're above the low that we had on that Thursday, and then the test on the Friday. That was a little bit lower, but it was, you know, rapid fire up, and then we had the huge rally going back up. So the futures had reached a low down right there the early part of the morning, and then rallied back up to the pivot point. But once it got right there, that's why these are important numbers to watch. That's where it failed and came down, broke back below this trading channel, and of course at the end of the day just kept on going and below the 127% projection. And that was projection is from this high down to where that bounce point was for the day, the first bounce point. And that projected lower we are underneath that. If we go underneath the low from what was it now 2 weeks ago, then we've got a 161.8 at 10,348, and you can see just under that we do have a declining trend line that could give support as well. So watch, those are important areas. The test of this low, then the 161, and then the one further on the SPX. You can see we went below the, I think this is a daily, or is this a 60 minute, waiting for it to show up here. It's coming. I think it's coming. There we go. The 50% retrace, you know, we'd held basically above that, but then we fell down. Now, if it keeps on going, it has, of course, this the test of the recent low, and then below that we have 1,060 would be the 61.8% retrace. And if you look left, you can see obviously we had been lower than that before. That's a pretty good line. That's been support several times. It was broken for a couple of days or a couple of weeks. For this week it was under, and this week it was under, and then interweek it was under. But basically it is a support area to watch. In fact, over here, the there was a low of here, 1039, and then 1010, or let's call it 1011. If we look at the day chart of S&P 500, this is the futures chart, going from this last, that was the low that we ran into, and then up at this high up at 1223. If we're using this as a projection coming down from this high down to this low under 1070. If we go there, then we're looking at possible 1028 or 975. These are long term, since this is a daily chart, but just showing you what those levels could be longer term, that is. But we're going to have some, even if we went there, we're going to have some nice rallies before that area. If we look at a shorter time frame chart, this one we posted that closed, this is a 360 minute chart. And this is from the 1190 high here to this low that we broke during the day on Monday. Their closer support at 1078, that would be an area to watch. And then that recent low at 1070, below that 1047, we're not going there right away. Anyway, so 1078, that may be a bounce there. We've got RSI at 36 on this 360 minute chart. But so 1078, one to watch, and then of course that 1070. Let's look at some other indices that we have here handy. This is the Russell 2000, and it looked like, you know, after the break here at 630, it looked maybe we'd come down here and just hold. And you can see on this 60-minute chart, it did bounce right here at this trend line, but then it came on down through, and this fib projection is based from the high up there to 716 down to this low at the 630. The break of that gives us 604. We did move below that, so the next fib number really from this projection is pretty much lower, down to 574. I don't think we'll see that right away, but these are areas to look at, and we'll do a short-term one as well, and we'll post that either tonight before the midnight posting or sometime tomorrow as well. We'll see how it goes on the overnight. We can take a look at the NASDAQ 100 as well, and this one came through its 2132 break. It came down below, almost down to S1, rallied back up to the point. In fact, at one time it came up to the pivot point as well. See how S1 was support and pivot point was resistance. Then it fell down to the 127.2 projection and a little bit lower than that as well. And we've got 2007. If it really came down lower, that's at the 161% projection on the downside. And I think there's one other chart as well that we wanted to show from the futures. And I guess that's just on the dollar. We skipped over gold, but we'll show you the dollar continued. Of course, we've been very bullish on the dollar since this breakdown here at 74, because it's been waiting to do that, and you've seen week after week we talk about it. So an area of resistance will be up here at the 78.6. That's at 80.563. That's an area to watch, and we'll show some other charts of that, because we've obviously long this one, and it's been on the watch list several times before. Okay, quickly, then the other things, gold did rally up. I don't have the futures of that handy, but you can see we're getting to it. These are taking so long to load, but you can see the bounce up about $36. It continued this bounce. And we do have a projection on that, but I just don't have it loaded, and we'll post that later, so you can catch that in the stream, no problem. So gold going up, you'd think the GDX switched as well, or turned up as well, but actually, the GDX short, it did not. We're waiting for this. Here we are, and you can see it's actually down 74 cents, but that's because the miners have not been responding as the gold bounce. They continue to go down, and so GDX has been going down as well. This has been a fantastic trade, as you know. In the couple months we're up tremendously, and that is same as SLV. So these appear to be good ones. Of course, they have for years for your 401ks, because you don't have to think about them too much, and not that many trades. And when they can do 70 to 100 and so percent a year, that's a pretty decent. SLV here, you can see, is not turned around, although it was up a couple percent, 58 cents. And so just be cautious on any of these. They could turn, as you know, because they've been down a lot and oversold, and it'll take us someone to spark it off and for a move back up. Okay, looking at some action from the day, from the watch list, we added about 10 new stocks on the watch list. About 5 of them did really well. FXP, this was short of China, and you know this one moved up about 6% on the day. So all of these, remember, the ones that are the ETFs, if the market rallies and then drops again, you can get right back into the same ones that done well generally, although this one's based on what the China market does, or the perception of what the China market will do at least. And we've got DRV, which hit the first trigger, and then it hit the second trigger, and then we posted that, watch that $16 level as well, $16.78 a level, and look what the high was. Did we nail that? You can look at the stream and say, we posted, watch the 200 day at 16.78, and that's what the high was, 16.78. So that was spot on. This was up 14% on the day. This was just beautiful. This is a real estate short, and we're happy we put that and some others on the watch list. Then we had some shorts as well on the watch list that also performed really well, and a couple of those we weren't too sure whether they'd trigger. Things were a little oversold, aha. And GS up, meaning it was lost 4.73%, which means it was good because it hit both triggers. The last one, not by too much, but by about 40 cents under the last one as well. So this triggered at 92. And change in that, or 92, and then that one's dropped nicely as well, as did Midas, or MDAS, and I am pushing the button. They're just not changing. Something's keeping things from moving swiftly, and maybe I can fix that. I will try. So Med Assets, are we back on? We are. So MDAS, Med Assets, did really well. As far as the short goes, it triggered the first short, and then it also triggered below the second one as well. So if the market continues down, these might have some to run. But do notice that they are getting in the very oversold territory if you look at the Williams indicator and the MACD as well. And then we had a bounce trade, and this one there's no exact place, and this is rough to trade because of the market, but you can see it did move up. I'm mentioning MELA, you know, and it had good volume as well. It's got to get rid of all the people that think that their approval letter, which is not final, they still have submit more things to the FDA for the devices clearance completely, and there's a lot of, you can read about that, all you have to do is Google it. But this one still looks like it's still going to go higher. It just looks like there's still some people are waiting to get out, but that it's not broken. It just hasn't gone back up. Another one of the short ones for the day, NUS. With a gain of 2.7%, hit the first trigger, not the second possibility one. It'll be under the Bollinger Band, so it could be that it bounces there as well, but you can see it's got a ways to go. I mean, it doesn't mean it's going to go there, but as far as it's certainly not oversold, it could come down and test these lows if the market continues lower, but that's where the trigger was. And Vertex, which is biotech, and this one had a pretty nasty looking chart, and this one did really well. And this was one of our favorites of the shorts, thinking this was more set up than the others. And because of this little candle right there, this wimpy candle at the try of the bounce on Friday, and that didn't work out, and the increased volume on Friday of that, and this worked out perfectly, and it came down to our dotted line, our first target area. So this one also with a gain of 6.93%. since it was short. Okay, other things that from the watch list already, we'll try and go through these even with this problem with the computer delay. So other ones from the watch list anyway that, this is from a couple of weeks ago, but there are ones that we expected to be longer term, like UUP, because this is for the dollar. It continued up. It is getting up to the upper, above the top Bollinger Band, and big, a couple gaps the last couple of days, big volume on it. You know, people are late and they're coming into it. But anyway, that was up nicely. And of course, the other way to trade that would be the EUO, which is being short the euro, but is a reverse fund, so that's the way it goes. And this one also, of course, moved up 2.9%, and this one had broken out and then came back down to test the same area and then moved up as well. Other shorts include DUG. These are also ETFs, as you know, and these continued, and this has been on the watch list for, they triggered back here and came back down and been moving up really nicely from the original, like $35 or $36, is now up at $42, and that's oil and gas short, because of course we've been bearish on oil and gas for several months since it dropped below its long-term resistance and was unable to move back above it. ERY, another one in the energy bear sector, also broke out at the same time, and that's been continuing to be a nice one. And then lastly on these would be DRV. I just wanted to remind you that if you get out of these things, they're on the watch list. You can always go back and check them, when the market rallies, and then when it drops again, go back and see how they're looking. And if they're still looking good, like these were, held the support areas, and they'd be good trades to just continue with. We don't need to post them each time. And of course, DRV, which is a real estate bear, continued up. Now, it also, we had pointed out that this one got to the 200-day EMA, and you can see that's exactly where it went to. Okay, now we've got additions to the watch list, and we've got longs and shorts on those. I'm sorry that we're having these delays, but without closing some program that I need, I think I can't do much about it. So we'll just wait. A BAP under $89 looks like a possible short, some increased volume. Any, remember, when we get into these situations where this was support back in August, it was support again here, it may be support. So if they don't break down, they may break up. So it doesn't mean it was a bad idea. It just, it went the opposite way, like breakouts sometimes turn out to be good shorts. Anyway, if this breaks down through this level, 89, our idea is to short that one. BGZ, on the other hand, is a 3X large cap bear. And so this one, if it pulls up, you can see it's got some resistance over here from early August. And it is above the top Bollinger Band, but if the big caps continue down over 51, at least for a day, maybe an okay trade. Another one on the long side would be BMY over about $32. And you'll be able to see that here in just a moment. I should be playing music in the background or something, but you can see it's a nice pattern here. And Bristol-Myers Squib had good increase in volume as well. It wasn't such a down day, you'd think this go. So if we get a turnaround in the market, maybe this one will move, I say, over about that $32. There's a couple stocks now that are also, well, there's another short and then another long to go. On the short side, we've got CFFN, and you'll be able to see that. And this looks like the area of 628. You can see it wasn't even, it got much, it was much, came up from much lower than 949, but over there 949. So this has been hanging around this area, maybe a bounce here. But below that, we could drop down maybe just to the 980 area and test that, or maybe a bit lower. But first we'll start off with the under 1028. On the, how about some soup, make you feel better. Campbell's looks like it was doing pretty good, and this is another one that you know, may have been able to break out here if the market wasn't so bad. It's right at the 200 day, so it does have all this resistance. It's not a perfect setup, but June, July, and all that, it's the resistance over there. But if we get a turnaround in the market, Campbell's over about $33, looks like the trade. Now, if tech continues weak, as Cisco is likely to follow along as well, this would then be a short, and this would be under about the $15.12, which you see the first little line, and then it's got the 1496 or 1490. So we'll say under the 1512. That's like the little 20 cent movement to see how it's going. If it doesn't look too good, you can exit it, and you know, without a loss. If it keeps on going, then you're in good shape, because maybe it'll come down. This isn't really a gap, it's supported next to it, but it may act like a gap and eventually come on down to that area if the market stays weak. We've got, you know, where we may have been long on one Bristol-Myers Squib, we've got Pfizer, which looks like that instead is not looking as good. And this could be on the downside. It could be support there, but that increased volume doesn't support that. So under 1730, it come down, maybe be not a long-term trade, but down to the 1660 area is a possibility. And then we have on the, I think this is on the long side, one more, and then we'll be done with these long delays. And that is PNM. This could go either way. So first, if we're in a bull market, we'd like to look at this one as a possible buy very soon, because you can see it closed right about there, that 16. And after it moved up on really nice volume, created this little trading area here, and come down to the support, may bounce. But in this case, it looks like if the market's weak, it may be a quick little short, maybe only down here to the 20 and 50-day average, and maybe a reversal. Anyway, it could be a bounce right here, or it could be a short, so you can decide depending on how it moves. Anyway, sorry for delays in the charts. Hope you have a great day trading. Thanks a lot for watching. We'll send tweets out during the day, so please pay attention to those. Otherwise, we'll be back again tomorrow with some new ideas. Thanks. Bye-bye.